Speed can't really try to hurt Canelo. Canelo's just gonna be too big, but Khan can make it difficult by, you know, moving around, using that ring, and try to go, you know, 12 rounds, you know, give him a boxing lesson. That's what he needs to do.
One thing very important is he needs to stick to his game plan. And I know Virgil has a good game plan. Khan needs to stick to his game plan. He can't try to please the crowd, because there's gonna be a lot of Mexicans, but there's also gonna be a lot of people from his country. He can't try to please them and try to see, because people want to see a fight. The fans there, they're gonna be drinking, they're gonna be having a good time, so they're gonna be screaming out for a war, and that's what Khan doesn't need. He needs to stick with his game plan, and if he does and doesn't make mistakes, he's got a shot, man. You know, boxing, anything could happen.
Now I gotta ask you guys last thing. I know you guys are hungry, you gotta go, you're taping all morning. A TV show, we'll tell them about it in the future. Mares Cuellar, you sparred Cuellar. Have you sparred Mares?
No, I haven't sparred Mares.
What do you guys think of that? You trained one of them in the past, you're training one of them now.
I trained Cuellar, you know, when he came to the United States, we won the world title and defended it a few times. He decided not to train with me, but, you know, things happen for a reason. It's part of boxing. He's not the first or last fighter that leaves the trainers, you know. The good thing about it is, if it wasn't for him not wanting to train with me, I would have never got Abner Mares. Now that I'm working with Abner Mares is such a great kid, very respectful, very talented, and following every instruction I'm giving him. And with that said, I think we're going to come out and surprise the world, because very few people think we got a shot, because Cuellar hits tremendously hard, but Abner has tremendous skills and tremendous speed. We're going to do what some people don't think we could do.
It's Pito's birthday. What are you buying him?
I'm taking him out. Taking him out.
Can we go too? It's gonna sound like you're gonna turn it up. He's 21.
I'm not going. Tomorrow you gotta come. You gotta come to the house, Ellie.
It's all right. Tomorrow I'll be at the house. Mayweather Pacquiao. They're seriously talking of a rematch. Really? Manny's team is really.
I'm sure they want him. Well, what about the money?
I think right now, first before that, I think Pacquiao needs to impress against Bradley. Because if he doesn't look too good, then people are gonna want to watch it. But that's why I think this time around, I think Pacquiao's gonna stop Bradley. I think he's gonna knock him out.
All right, there you have Mike here. By the way, that video of you knocking out the trumpet player is just blowing up. It has 200,000 views already.
Yes.
Yeah. It caught on fire this week. Somebody picked it up.
Yeah. Where I'm with it.
Tell people where to follow you.
Mikey Garcia on Twitter and Team Mikey Garcia on Instagram.
And at Robert Garcia, Garcia Boxing on Twitter for Robert Garcia.
Boxing,
stay tuned.
What is it?
FuseReport.com. Basic Crack Reporting.
All right, Italy.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For EsNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback.